Thanks for watching another edition of Politics with Powers. I'm Andalee Powers, and we're going to talk about the 18th Congressional District. Chele Farley, Republican business executive challenging Sean Patrick Maloney for New York's 18th Congressional District, is the little engine that could. She faces an uphill battle running against a well-funded incumbent with deep ties to the political establishment. However, she's running an innovative campaign using clever tactics to get her message out and erode support for the incumbent. Take what she did earlier this week. She took a New York Post page 6 report saying that Sean Patrick Maloney was no longer interested in being a congressman, but more interested in being a talking head on MSNBC or a lobbyist. And she wrote a letter to Maloney's donors letting them know that they're spending their hard-earned money to elect a guy who doesn't want the job. She reminded these donors that 2 years ago, he was the candidate for New York State Attorney General up until 2 months before the general election. She encouraged these donors to ask for a refund, and then she plastered this letter all over social media for everyone to see. Now, this out-of-the-box tactic does a couple things. One, it shows Farley's supporters that she has spunk and that she has fight in her. Two, it puts Maloney on the defensive and may force him to spend more time doing damage control than cultivating new donors. Three, when the big institutional Democrat donors and PACs are looking for where to put their dollar, where it's gonna have the biggest impact, they might skip over the guy whose heart's not in it. And four, the letter and the focus on Maloney's waning interest in the job lowers enthusiasm of his supporters, which will cut his volunteer base and ultimately sap energy out of his reelection campaign. With 5.5 months to Election Day, Chele Farley is showing Representative Sean Patrick Maloney that he has a fight on his hands. In other news, Puliafito, the Manhattan doorman and Republican running for New York State Assembly against Assemblywoman Rebecca Seawright in the deep blue Upper East Side District, got some great news from the highest court in the state yesterday. The New York State Court of Appeals ruled that Seawright failed to properly file her Democrat petitions, and now in order to retain her seat, she is reduced to only running as a write-in candidate. Even as a write-in, she does have a good shot, being that it is such a Democrat district. But I think Lou Puliafito, who takes care of his grandkids by day and is a doorman by night, has a real shot at being the first Republican elected to Manhattan in 2 decades. Instead of Mr. Smith goes to Washington, it very well may be Mr. Puliafito goes to Albany. And I think that has a nice ring to it. If you missed Kieran's interview with Mr. Puliafito on Issues and Interviews from the other day, make sure you subscribe to our Hudson Power Broker YouTube channel so you don't miss another video. And thanks for watching Politics with Powers. I'm Andalee Powers.